case briefs and so much more. LS Data's got what you're looking for.
In the 1895 case of Hilton v. Guyot, the Supreme Court of the United States was faced with the challenge of determining the enforceability of foreign judgments. The principles of comity of nations and public order played a significant role in the court's decision-making process. This case, along with Ritchie v. McMullen, brought to light several crucial questions about the admissibility of foreign judgments as evidence and the grounds for challenging them. In the absence of specific legislation, the court had to rely on the examination of judicial decisions, legal commentaries, and the practices of civilized nations to establish the applicable law for such matters. Ultimately, the court held that foreign judgments could be recognized and enforced in other countries based on the principle of comity, as long as they satisfied certain criteria, such as competent jurisdiction, civilized jurisprudence, and a clear record. Nevertheless, the court also allowed for the challenge of foreign judgments if they violated the laws of the recognizing country or lacked jurisdiction. This landmark decision underscored the importance of reciprocal arrangements and public order in determining the enforceability of foreign judgments, and it set a precedent for future cases dealing with similar cross-border legal issues.
Case briefs and so much more. LS Data's got what you're looking for. Visit lse.law, elevate your mind. Leave the stress of class.